You're listening to Radio 3. It's 4 o'clock, and now we do go to Tewkesbury Abbey for today's broadcast of Choral Evensong. The Canticles are sung to the second service by William Byrd, and the anthem, with music by Sir Charles Villa Stanford, is The Lord is My Shepherd, the words taken from Psalm 23. The service opens with an introit by the American composer Randall Thompson. Alleluia, Amen.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe of him.
O Lord, open thou our lips.
And our mouths shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O
those appointed for the 18th evening of the month, numbers 93 and 94.
Thank you. Here begins the 36th verse of the 22nd chapter of the book called Numbers. When Balak heard that Balaam had come, he went out to meet him at the city of Moab on the boundary formed by the Arnon at the extremity of the boundary. And Balak said to Balaam, "Did I not send to you to call you? Why did you not come to me? Am I not able to honor you?" Balaam said to Balak, "No, I have come to you. Have I now any power at all to speak anything? The word that God puts in my mouth, that must I speak." Then Balaam went with Balak, and they came to Kirath Huzoth. And Balak sacrificed oxen and sheep and sent to Balaam and to the princes who were with him. And on the morrow Balak took Balaam and brought him up to Bamoth Baal, and from there he saw the nearest of the people. And Balaam said to Balak, "Build for me here 7 altars, and provide for me here 7 bulls and 7 rams." Balak did as Balaam had said, and Balak and Balaam offered on each altar a bull and a ram. And Balaam said to Balak, "Stand beside your burnt offering, and I will go. Perhaps the Lord will come to meet me, and whatever he shows me, I will tell you." And he went to a bare height, and God met Balaam, and Balaam said to him, "I have prepared the 7 altars, and I have offered upon each altar a bull and a ram." And the Lord put a word in Balaam's mouth and said, "Return to Balak, and thus you shall speak." And he returned to him, and lo, he and all the princes of Moab were standing beside his burnt offering. And Balaam took up his discourse and said, "From Aram Balak has brought me, the king of Moab, from the eastern mountains. Come curse Jacob for me, and come denounce Israel. How can I curse whom God has not cursed? How can I denounce whom the Lord has not denounced? For from the top of the mountains I see him, from the hills I behold him. Lo, a people dwelling alone, and not reckoning itself among the nations. Who can count the dust of Jacob, or number the fourth part of Israel? Let me die the death of the righteous, and let my end be like his." And Balak said to Balaam, "What have you done to me? I took you to curse my enemies, and behold, you have done nothing but bless them." And he answered, "Must I not take heed to speak what the Lord puts in my mouth?" Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. 7th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, and verse 11. Soon afterward, Jesus went to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a great crowd went with him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, behold, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow, and a large crowd from the city was with her. And when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said to her, "Do not weep." And he came and touched the bier, and the bearers stood still. And he said, "Young man, I say to you, arise." And the dead man sat up and began to speak, and he gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, saying, "A great prophet has arisen among us, and God has visited his people." And this report concerning him spread through the whole of Judea and all the surrounding country. The disciples of John told him of all these things. And John, calling to him two of his disciples, sent them to the Lord, saying, "Are you he who is to come, or shall we look for another?" And when the men had come to him, they said, "John the Baptist has sent us to you, saying, 'Are you he who is to come, or shall we look for another?'" In that hour, he cured many of diseases and plagues and evil spirits, and on many that were blind he bestowed sight. And he answered them, "Go and tell John what you have seen and heard. The blind receive their sight, the lame walk, lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear, the dead are raised up, the poor have good news preached to them. And blessed is he who takes no offense at me." Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Give peace in our time, O Lord.
the King of glory, who hast exalted thine only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph unto thy kingdom in heaven. We beseech thee, leave us not comfortless, but send to us thine Holy Ghost to comfort us, and exalt us unto the same place whither our Saviour Christ is gone before, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thine only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. The anthem is a setting by Charles Stanford of Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, therefore can I lack nothing.
Thank you.
we continue to give thanks to God for the glorious ascension of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And in the faith of our risen and ascended Lord, we pray for his church throughout the world, remembering today in our cycle of prayer the Episcopal Church of Brazil, and particularly in the dioceses of southern and central Brazil. In this diocese of Gloucester, we pray for the deanery of North Leech, and today for the parishes of Sevenhampton, with Charlton Abbots, Halling and Whittington, for Philip Hobbs the parish priest, and the people whom he serves. O God, who by thy marvelous majesty didst after thy resurrection from the dead ascend into heaven in the presence of thine apostles, grant us the aid of thy loving kindness, that according to thy promise thou mayest ever dwell with us on earth, and we with thee in heaven, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit thou reignest, God for ever and ever.
Amen.
We give thanks to God for his great gift of music, praying for all who make music in the cathedrals and parish churches of our land. And more especially, we pray for all our choral foundations, remembering headmasters of choir schools from all over England, meeting at this time here in Tewkesbury. O Lord God Almighty, whose glory cherubim and seraphim and all the hosts of heaven with ceaseless voice proclaim, pour down upon us thy servants such a spirit of faith, reverence, and joy as shall lift both our hymns and our lives unto thee, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the parish, our special intention today is to pray for the souls of all the faithful departed, particularly those who have died in the course of the past month. And as we rejoice in the hope given us by our risen and ascended Lord, so we pray that he will bring each one of us to our true home in heaven. Bring us, O Lord our God, at our last awakening into the house and the gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music, no fears nor hopes, but one equal possession, no ends nor beginnings, but one equal eternity, in the habitations of thy glory and dominion, world without end.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen.
From the ancient and modern revised hymn book, number 155. Our Lord, his passion ended, hath gloriously ascended.